I was at a yard sale the other day and found two Mother Goose toys, and I wanted to show them to y'all, because one in particular is pretty unusual, but this one's normal. I'll go ahead and video her first, and then I'll get the unusual one to show you. This one, she is a first edition, and her eyelid fell out, but I've got it right here, so... Yeah, she is a first edition. Her head does not turn back and forth. And she has a hinged battery cover. The other Mother Goose toys have a removable battery cover. And according to the tag, if I can find the date, or if y'all can see the date, probably not, she was made in 1996 until Worlds of Wonder went bankrupt. But, all she had with her was her original little necktie, but I've got an extra bonnet for her to wear. And she's in good shape, just pretty dirty. I'll lift up her wing and show you how her fur is pretty discolored around the seams, but she works great. I've gotten her mouth to start moving. Her eyes don't blink yet, but, you know, I keep working with her. It'll take some time, but they'll come loose eventually. And I've got to get her... her eyelid glued back on, but otherwise she's in pretty good condition, just needs a bit of cleaning. Now here's the other Mother Goose that I got. Now this one, like I said, it's pretty odd. I'll show her from the side just so you can see. She has been completely taken apart, had her insides removed, and stuffed. So her neck is insanely huge, and she looks down and to the left, or to her right, rather. I don't know why anyone would completely destroy a perfectly good toy, but as you can see, the neck is not supposed to be curved like that. The base, you can see the post just barely sticking out right here. That's where her head's supposed to sit. But, yeah, like I said, someone completely took her apart. Even her wings are sewed together, but you can feel on the side where the tape player goes. If you press in, it's hollow. There's no tape player there. And on the other side, same thing. There's no battery compartment. So I don't know what her story is. Oh, another thing, her eyes have been glued to her face from the inside. So, like I said, someone took her completely apart, removed everything, restuffed her, and sewed her back together. But, her mouth will open and close, but you can feel there's no motor back there. It's really loose. And she was wearing a doll's bonnet and a bandana around her neck that are not Mother Goose outfits. I don't know where those came from, but... I took them off just so y'all could get a good look at the curvature of her neck, and they put some extra padding in her back too, which is kind of ugly looking, but like I said, I don't know why anyone would completely destroy a toy, but she looks pretty, so I guess her only purpose will be to sit on top of my shelf and look down at an angle and look cute. But yeah, poor, I call her a taxidermied Mother Goose. She'll be my, my prized goose sitting on my shelf for forever. But yeah, another thing, this is a really, really well planned out job. I don't know who did it, if the lady I bought her from had someone do it for her because the toy broke, I do not know, but, there are no seams, no visible seams where they would have taken her fur off, so it's just, it's astounding. I don't know who, why, what, but if you know anything, if you have a story behind this goose, please let me know, because I'm completely clueless. The lady I bought from wasn't sure. It actually wasn't hers, it was her mother-in-law's, I think, but either way, this is a very unusual stuffed Mother Goose toy, but Again, if you know anything about this bird, where she came from, who restuffed her, where her insides are, please leave a note in the comments section.